YouTube, Nanovic here once again. In response to the Breaking Out of Bounds video for Shattered Mass, one of my clan mates, Coley Bree, had made a request for me to show off the Haunted Cave. She didn't call it that, but I believe it's commonly known as the Haunted Cave. This one's a bit more well known, so I'm not sure if it's really worthy of its own video, but I might as well show it off and maybe show a couple slides at the end of using this trick elsewhere. Now, to get here, you're going to want to head over to Songshu Isle, which is right near the, to the right of Songshu Isle, to the Sentinel Outpost, which is right near Black Ram Narrows. I'll show you again on the map when it loads, but you may have already seen it there. So right here, the Sentinel Outpost, and you're going to want to walk over to this corner here. And the fastest way to do that is just go right over these two rocks. Just head right over here. Now, getting in here, it's a bit easier. There's a couple of ways to do it. I'm going to try to show you both ways, but it's a lot easier to do this particular trick if you throw 25 points in a movement speed under your Hongmoon focus. So, when you get over here, you'll find this black and red portal, meaning it's a disabled field, a field you can't enter. If you try to walk into it, it'll bounce you off. You'll see these portals from time to time all over the place, and you can use this trick to get behind literally any of them. You want to run up, jump, and just before it rejects you, you hit spacebar, and you're going to start bouncing up and down. I'll try to replicate that here. But in this particular portal, and this one only, you can also just walk here and turn around and get behind the corner here. Take another step back. Oops, I didn't mean to hit one there. And I had it there. And you'll start bouncing. Now I'm trying something different with the audio here, so it should be better than the previous video. Really, I lag at the... Sometimes I hate this game. I tried this the first time recording before I decided to do the audio. I accidentally found the other way to get in, which is the whole standing there, right here, and turning around during the drop. And then you just press spacebar, spacebar and W. But there's a couple ways to do it. You can run at it from an angle, you can run at it from far, or you can run up this wall here and jump. Either way, when you get it, you're going to start bouncing repeatedly. When you're new to glitching through this portal or glitching through any, getting a longer running start and a lower camera angle makes it easier, because you want to jump right here when your character has just barely made it past the portal. That was a bit too late. Do it right. It'll continually bounce. Try one more time, and then I'm going to cut the recording and come back when I'm in there, because it's been almost 5 minutes since I started this recording and I'm not in there yet, and it only took me 45 seconds last time. I mean, it took me 4 tries, but still. Whatever, be right back. So that's interesting. There we go. Okay, so this is what you want to see. once you've done this, you've already made it inside. All you have to do is slowly turn around to face outside, and then hold W to walk forward. If nothing happens, which it might not, SS, and then hold W. And if it still doesn't work, Q. It's working slowly. It's usually a lot faster than this, but whatever. There. Okay. I'm gonna stop myself from bouncing by hitting guard one of these times. No. I'm just gonna go to the side. There we go. As you press or hold W, you may even want to run a bit. It should bounce you slightly back further and further each time. There we go. There we go. Alright, cool. And that's all there is to it. Welcome to the haunted cave. Now, inside of here, you'll notice there's a lot of remains, a lot of skulls and everything around. This is very Tomb of Exiles motif. Or Forgotten Tomb. One of those two. I don't know. I'm pretty sure Tomb of Exiles. Anyway. A lot of remains around on a lot of these little basic rooms where you would expect to see between like 2 and 8 random, you know, red shirt monsters, and then a hole in the ground. You've seen this many times before, like in Sogan's Lament and all over the place. This you used to see in all the old dungeons where you had this spiral going down. It was almost tradition for their dungeons back in the time when this was being made. Now, I'm not 100% sure on if this once was an actual dungeon, say in the Korean version, or in some beta version that eventually got removed, or if this was a dungeon that they never finished and cut before it finished. But it does end at what is ostensibly the first boss room for the dungeon, and this is where it gets the name of Haunted Cave. You got the fire effect, which would have been part of a cinematic, you can tell because it's actually on a timer. When you reach a certain part, it starts, and then it counts down, and then that orange fire never shows back up. But then you got the purple ghostly fire and all the remains laying around, the nice purple torches, the sculptures on the walls, or in the walls rather, and then the giant headless Buddhist statue. The same one that is actually in the Tomb of Exiles, except it's inverted. The other hand is the broken hand in there. It's the one you run out, jump on, flip the switch, and opens the door to that somewhat secret room, and if you haven't killed the spiders, there's a chance that the queen spider will spawn, and if you kill it, there's a chance that you'll get the spider horns, this one here. There's a chance that you get that spider fang horns adornment from. But anyway, supposedly there's a way on top of the statue. I haven't found it yet. But it has something to do with... I was on there, dang it. That was gonna be first try, too. That was, that was almost so good. There we go, second try. Okay. Has something to do... getting on that last torch, supposedly. Anyway, you'll notice there's a little ledge up there. You can try to run and jump on it, but the invisible wall starts right with the edge of the wall here and goes up, so you can't actually fit into that empty space. So there's no real way that I've found to get higher than the torches, so getting on that statue, as far as I can tell, is impossible. And I've never seen any screenshots of anyone making it all the way up, but I've been told that people have found a way. What I'm curious personally about, because there's a lot of places where the invisible wall, as you can see here, has these jagged edges and corners and seams, which means it may be very possible to get out of bounds in here and check underneath this room. Because in every boss room, in every dungeon, the boss asset, the model and texture and all that, is saved underneath the boss room. So I'd be curious to see what's actually under the map right here, to see if the boss was finished for this dungeon. But anyway, this has been the Haunted Cave. I hope you enjoyed, and thanks for watching. once you get to this bouncing thing, you want to make sure you're facing straight out, SS once, and then hold W. So like you want to walk forward. And as you can see, it's going to push you back to a certain distance.